So you've finally got your fingers into these stretchy power chord shapes. So now we need some songs to play. So this video is five, actually six, power chord based riffs, going from very simple two finger version of the chord right up to a song that uses the three finger power chord shape and flies all over the neck at 179 beats per minute, which is pretty fast. Okay, here we go with riff number one. This one is Modern Way by the Kaiser Chiefs. Really easy two finger power chord riff. Starts off on fret four on the A string, goes up to fret seven, down to fret five on the E string, and then back to the chord we started on, fret four on the A string. And that's the main part of the riff that we want to kind of concentrate for this part of the lesson. So it's this simple part which just goes from there . We're focusing on that part because that's kind of this nice easy introduction to power chords. It's a real song you can play using these simple power chords, and it'll get you playing through nice and easily. If you find it difficult to change chord with that limited amount of time when you're letting those chords ring out like this, then just cut off the ring. Don't let it sustain so much. You can go pick, pick, two, three, four, and ba-da, two, three, four. Giving you plenty of time to get that next chord set up before you have to start playing again. And once you get used to the changes, your hands are kind of comfortable jumping from one fret to the next and changing string and all those things they're going to need to do in this song, then you can start adding in the sustain and letting the chords ring out for a longer period of time. And then you'll be sounding more and more like the song as you get used to those chord changes. So that is our first song, Modern Way by the Kaiser Chiefs. So hopefully you made it all the way through, or at least got that main riff of Modern Way by the Kaiser Chiefs. And now what? We want to take it up to the next level. So we're going to look at the three finger version of the power chord. The version of the chord we're going to need starts on the fifth fret on the low E string. That's where my first finger is going to go. Then I've got the seventh fret on the string underneath with my third finger, and then my seventh fret on the D string as well with the little finger, giving me this A5 power chord. And all you have to do is rearrange the order you pick those strings to get the riff for The Hardest Button to Button by the White Stripes, which sounds like this. That's it. That's pretty much the riff. It just repeats that. And then once you've done that three times, you do a very similar riff, which is on the seventh fret, up to the 10th fret. And that's the main part of the song that we're interested in as far as this video is concerned. If you want to carry on with the strumming parts as well, it's the same chords again, we're just strumming them. So at that section where there's a constant strumming pattern, and then towards the end of the example there's a chopped up strum on each chord with a big gap allowing you to change. And this example is taking us up to the three finger version of the power chord with The Hardest Button to Button by the White Stripes. So far with our examples, we've been concentrating on power chord shapes, the two finger shape and the three finger shape, and then picking the strings in certain kind of riff formations. And now we're getting much more into the strumming of the chord. So we're going to stick with our three finger version of the power chord. We're going to turn our attention to the right hand or picking hand strumming technique. So I'm going to hold down the three finger version of the power chord up on fret 10, and I'm going to play this rhythm. And that is the rhythm we're going to need to play the song Teenage Kicks by the Undertones, which actually takes that rhythm and then moves it around the neck a little bit. So what we actually want is that rhythm, which goes down, 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 up, down, up, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, and moves it around the 10th fret, the 9th fret, and the 7th fret like this. And then it goes back up the other way. We're going from the 7th fret up to fret 9 before we start the riff all over again. The rhythm's slightly different here. It goes down, 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 up, down, up, up, down, up, down, up, down. But that last chord is up on fret 9. That last strum, sorry, is up on fret 9. So we're going to start off on fret 7 and go. And then we start the whole riff all over again, and that goes round and round and round, and that's pretty much the majority of Teenage Kicks by the Undertones. There's another section where it drops down to fret 3. Starts climbing back up again. And then we're back into the main riff, but you'll see all of that in the tab. So that's the next part, is taking the power chord and trying to apply some strumming patterns and moving slightly larger jumps around the neck with Teenage Kicks by the Undertones. Now we're really getting the hang of these power chords. We've got our chord changes going, we've got some strumming going, we've got some picking going. It's all kind of coming together. So we want to up the ante, we want to add in a little bit of speed and start looking at power chords down at the wider end of the neck where the frets are nice and far apart. With one of the most famous power chord riffs of all time, which is You Really Got Me by the Kinks. Possibly the first intentional recording of a distorted guitar tone way back in the 60s. And that famous riff goes like this. So we're starting off again with the three finger power chord way down on fret 1, and we're moving between fret 1 and fret 3. So one of the main things to think about with this riff is the rhythm of when you start playing. So we don't want to get 1, 2, 3, 4. Because the feel of that riff is completely off. So you're coming on the and of 4, so that's 1, 2, 3, 4. So beat 1, where the bar actually starts, is on that second chord of the riff. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3. And to help us get the feel right for this riff and come in on that offbeat, it can be useful to start with an up strum so that you play that heavier down strum on beat 1. So you go up, down, up, down, up. And once you've got the hang of playing the riff between fret 1 and fret 3, all you have to do is the same thing in different areas around the neck. So when we move up, after playing that first riff about 12 times, I think it is, we're moving up to fret 3, and we're moving between fret 3 and fret 5. So then we're doing the same chord changes between fret 3 and fret 5, but we're on a different string set with the first finger on the A string this time. So, and we do that a bunch of times, hit that third fret power chord on the A string, and then start all over again. So concentrating on getting some nice fast chord changes here and moving a riff around the neck with You Really Got Me by the Kinks. We'll be right back. So moving on to riff number 5, we're going from possibly the first ever intentional distorted guitar tone recorded in the 60s with You Really Got Me, right up to possibly the most distorted guitar, famous guitar riff ever, which is Song 2 by Blur. So most of the gloriously ridiculous fuzz sound for this song actually comes from the bass, but I've changed the way that the song's played in this just a little bit to give us a bit more of a challenge for our power chord. So the main riff of the song starts way, way up on fret 14. So if you're playing this on acoustic guitar with restricted high fret access, that's going to be pretty tricky to get up to. So far we've been talking about 3-finger versions of the power chord. At this point, I'm going to switch from using 3 fingers to play the power chord shape on this high section to using the first finger holding down the root note, which in this case is fret 14 on the E string, and the third finger barring both the A string and the D string, so that I can get my fingers into these tiny, tiny little frets up this end of the neck. If I try and do that with 3-finger shape, it's just a little bit more awkward and uncomfortable for me, so I'm gonna switch to using 1 finger for the root note and the third finger barring across both the A and the D string. And then the main riff goes from fret 14 to fret 12 and jumps down to the A string, goes fret 12, fret 14, and fret 16. And the riff sounds like this. At which point that crazy, ridiculous, overdriven fuzz sound comes in, which is mainly the bass guitar. I've watched a couple of live videos of this, and Graham Coxon seems to stay up on that high section for most of the way through the song. But for my version of this song, I'm gonna take that riff and move it down a whole octave. So we're way down on the F sharp on fret 2 of the low E string, moving from that F sharp power chord shape on fret 2 to an E5 power chord shape. That's a little bit like E minor, but you're only playing 3 strings, don't strum the whole thing. To an A5 power chord shape, so that's just the first 3 strings of an A chord. And then up to a B5 power chord on fret 2 of the A string. Then up to fret 4 for a C sharp power chord. That's fret 4 of the A string, giving us the whole riff. So we've got a pretty massive leap of a chord change in this example. So we're right up on fret 16. This is definitely the highest power chord in the whole of this video. And we're going to move from there right down to fret 2. That's a 14 fret jump chord change, which is probably the biggest chord change you're ever going to come across in most songs. So that massive jump of a chord change is probably going to take a little bit of practice, but the main focus of this song is it's just a pretty fun riff to play. So towards the end of the song, there's the addition of an extra riff added in here, which I think again is played by the bass, but I've incorporated it into the power chord riff just to make it more fun to play, a little bit more of a challenge, and that is a slide between the F sharp power chord on fret 2 and a 5th fret sliding E string note, which goes like this. And then you'll carry on with the rest of the riff. On the original song, the main chords carry on going. Well, I think the bass player does that little riff, but I just like the sound of playing it like that. So, this is riff number 5, Song 2 by Blur. We'll be right back. And I can't make a video about power chord riffs without including something by Greenday. So this is going back to 90s era Greenday with a song called Welcome to Paradise, and the tempo for this one, everything else has been around the 130, 135 beats per minute mark. This one is jumping up to 179 beats per minute. So we're bringing in a bit of speed, some nice fast chord changes, lots of strumming, pretty easy chord changes. There's just mainly the speed is the thing that's going to catch us out here. So we've got starting up on fret 7 on the A string, using that same good old three finger power chord shape, and we're moving between fret 7 for the E chord, fret 5 for the D chord, and then up to the E string, fret 5 for that A chord. And the main intro is based around a fast moving power chord riff, which sounds like this. And then when the verse starts, we're going to expand on that riff a little bit and bring in some left hand muting, which is where we're going to release the pressure of the chord to get a muted sound like that, so we can play the chord and release the pressure of that fretting hand, which is going to stop the chord dead in its track to give us a nice cut up kind of staccato sort of sound, which sounds like this. So for that stabbing kind of cut off section of the end, we want to be holding down the chord shape when we want the chord to ring out, and then releasing the pressure of the left hand when we want that chord to cut off short, so we can get long chords like this, or short cut off, sounds like that, for different sections of the song. And then we're going to start jumping around the fretboard a little bit, so we're going to go from And in this example, we're starting to explore different ways of playing the same things using power chords. So if I play a power chord on fret 3 of the A string, I get a C5 power chord like that. If I play a power chord on fret 8 of the low E string, I get the same C5 power chord. So there's a section in this song where it rises up through the chords, and the first time round I play this version, going to fret 3. Second time round, I go up to the 8th fret. That's just to demonstrate how you can play the same thing in more than one way. So there'll be a lot of you out there thinking that you have to play this exactly the same way that Green Day play it. In my opinion, if as long as you play the chords right and the song sounds good, then you can use either one of those chords and it's not going to make a huge amount of difference. As a good rule of thumb, what usually makes sense when you're thinking about which chord to use, think about what chord you're going to next. If you're going to stay around the lower end of the guitar, then that third fret makes sense. If you're going to move back up towards the higher end of the guitar, then maybe using that higher 8th fret version of the chord would be more useful to help you play the song more smoothly. It's up to you. So there you have it, 6 power chord based tracks, moving you from very simple picking, just on 2 strings, to slightly trickier, much faster paced, 3-finger version of the power chord, lots of very fast strumming, 179 beats a minute, crazy power chord riffing rock at the end there. So hopefully this video will help you progress from just getting the hang of power chords and doing something with them that sounds like a song, right up to pushing what you're capable of doing at the moment and getting you into playing some slightly more challenging power chord based stuff towards the end of the video. So once you've got the hang of the 6 power chord bass riffs in this video, there are loads more out there. There's Iron Man by Black Sabbath, there's Smells Like Teen Spirit by Nirvana, there's countless others. So go check out Ultimate Guitar and other YouTube videos and you'll be able to find tons and tons of power chord bass riffs. So if you know of any other great power chord based riffs, then let us know in the comments section below so that other people can have a go at playing those songs too. Thanks a lot for watching, I'll see you next time.